Okay, so we've made it to Nevada. Just put some gas, and now I gotta add a little bit of oil, top it off. So, see you guys then. Okay, so right now we're in real time. I'm making the next video right now, which is the video you're watching right now. I lost a bunch of footage. I lost all the footage from Reno. I only have one small little video of when we went to the car museum in there, and this is from my phone, so it's just gonna be a quick thing I'm showing. But yeah, I lost it. I'm also gonna slip in a picture in there. But we went to Reno as well, and then we ended up heading to Idaho the next morning. So this is the National Automobile Museum in Reno, and here are just a few clips that I was able to get from my phone since I lost the data. But look at how beautiful these vehicles look. These are old 1920s, 1930s, amazing. Okay, so like earlier in the video, I also lost some footage in Idaho. The great thing is the footage of the RZR that we were driving in got all of that. So that's what you're gonna be watching right now. The rest of Idaho, it's gone and it's in memory now. But the RZR, it's gonna be popping up right now.
Do you see like a number up here that it shows that it's recording?
I see a number, yeah. I see a red light blinking, I see the time.
Yeah, it's recording.
It's recording? Okay.
I threw my phone in here.
I put my phone in there. Oh. Oh. Nice. Ready, Joey? You really know how to drive.
Oh,
oh my god.
You can go to four-wheel drive. This thing's a little different, isn't it?
Oh yeah.
Open
gates.
Okay. So, this.
Yep.
So this gentleman right here, his name is Abe Johnson. He's a very good friend of my uncle, Mario Ramirez, which you will see he is in the back seat, and he's the older looking guy. The white one is my friend Joey, in case you guys didn't know. But yes, Abe Johnson, we are very grateful that he was able to take us out on a ride on this day, because we arrived in Idaho about, let's say, 6 o'clock the day before. And last notice, my uncle called him, let him know, hey, can we go for a ride? And he's like, yeah. We got up very early that morning, around 5:30. And yeah, just very short notice and very nice guy. And it was one of the highlights of the trip.
So what's the point of all the gates?
So there's good. Yeah, go ahead and close it. There is.
It is not good.
Yes. Thanks. There is a particular, like, one of the largest farming.
So it's really important that we close it.
Yeah.
Then it'll, you know, that Joyce family can get pissed and all the and then half our riding area.
Gone. I'm videoing the entire journey.
Are you doing on YouTube?
Yep.
Put my YouTube link on yours. I have a YouTube that's growing pretty quick, actually.
Really?
Yeah, I'm up to 1,100 subscribers. One of my videos has 500,000 views.
Wow. Yeah, I'm only at about 5 subscribers.
It's all for what I do for work.
Construction?
Look up here, Johnny.
Huh?
Look up here.
Ah.
That nasty thing is called a Mormon cricket. Disgusting.
Good bait for fishing.
Are they?
Yeah, I am.
Are you gonna take some home?
No. My wife loses her mind. Like, if one falls in here, yeah, she'll be sitting in the back with the kids screaming her head off.
No?
That's gross.
Because there's some people that eat crickets, like dip them in chocolate or fry them up.
I
know.
That's fucking gross.
Yeah.
Is
there
a cow?
Cow?
Oh, yeah.
He's just looking at the sun. Just yelling.
Just trying to poo out here.
Thank you.
So here we are. We are at the cabin right now. There, as you can see, it tells you, if you pause, you could read it. It's about, if I'm not mistaken, that the brothers, some of the early settlers, came and settled down here. Now we're walking in, and as you can see, it's very small. The roof is very low that Abe himself can't even stand completely straight. That what you're looking at is a wood stove. You would use it mainly for heat. You could also cook on top of it, but it was for heat, especially in those cold winters. It's absolutely beautifully maintained. And fun fact, you could actually stay here. You could camp there. It's for everybody. You just gotta keep it clean and respectful. There, I'm not too sure what I'm saying. Oh, it's one of the early settlers, Ernesto. And here we are looking at a sign-in book. So here you get to write your name down and show that, hey, you visited this place. You write your name, you give your signature, and you put your date. Obviously, mine is the best, Jonathan Ramirez. We were there the 10th of July, 3 days after my birthday. Beautiful. Absolutely fantastic. I know I am saying that. All right. Now you close it, you lock it up so that no critters just walk in, and to keep it for the next generation. Now I'm walking around, as you can see how it's been kept up over the years. Now I highly doubt that all that is original, but a lot of it should be original. There is a pond that looks like it was a storage area. However, I am not 100% sure, but I'm pretty sure it is. Oh. And I also was singing Into the Thick of It, just so you know. Now I'm walking out, and right over there, you'll see a metal fenced-in area. And that right there, with that tiny little shed, that's where they used to keep their horses. This all used to only be able to be reached by horses. Now we have 4x4s and you could go anywhere. This right here, if I'm not mistaken, is where they filmed Shrek, and he came out of here. So yeah, Shrek was in Idaho. He was definitely using that. It smelled like he used it.